हेलो हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट द एनर्जी सिग्नल एंड पावर सिग्नल. इट इज़ वेरी इजी कंसेप्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड. इफ वी नो द बेसिक्स देन इट इज़ वेरी इजी टू अंडरस्टैंड द कंसेप्ट ऑफ एनर्जी सिग्नल एंड पावर सिग्नल. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट अवर डिस्कशन विथ सिंपल वन ओम्स लॉ एंड रजिस्टर विथ करंट फ्लोइंग रजिस्टर अक्रॉस विच अ वोल्टेज ड्रॉप विल बी occur. Okay, so we will begin our discussion by just I will draw one diagram for you. Consider a resistor R which is 1 ohm. For the sake of simplicity and for the normalization purpose, we have taken a 1 ohm resistor and current I is flowing through it, due to which due to which voltage V will occur across the resistor. So therefore we know that what is voltage. Voltage is nothing but work done per unit charge. And what is current, that is I, that is Q by T, rate of flow of current. Okay, Q by T. If we multiply V and I, then what we will get? W by Q divided by into Q by T. So QQ will be get cancelled. So V into I is nothing but W by T. And what is W by T? W by T is nothing but power. So as it is a power, so what we say that P is nothing but V into I. If you multiply voltage and current, then we will get the power. That is simple concept that we have seen during our first year of engineering. Okay, so in electrical engineering we have studied in this subject that P is nothing but voltage into current. So this is our start point from which we can expand our discussion. Okay, so let us start our next part. I will erase this for you. So what is the next thing? Now as we know that P is nothing but P into I. And by Ohm's law we can say that V square by R and I square R. And we have taken R equals to nothing but 1 ohm. So what we get? P equals to V square equals to I square. Now let us say that is X square, say. Okay, so what will happen now? We have power, that is V square equals to I square, that is the X square. Now we will convert this into our time variable. How to convert this in time variable? It is very easy to understand. So if we implement a time variable, that is P of T is nothing but V of T, which is I of T, which is equals to X square of T. Okay, so this we have with us, that is X square of T. Now I am moving one step ahead. Okay, so please pay attention. Now suppose I have to calculate the energy. What I should do? What is the formula for energy from the physics? it is very simple that if we multiply power with t variable, that is nothing but the energy, correct? So, and vice versa of this is, if so p of t equals to e of t divided by t. So if the energy is divided by time, that will give us power, or work done divided by time, that is nothing but the power. So these two, energy and power, are very much same, only the difference is of the time. One, if we multiply power with time, then we will get the energy. If we divide energy by time, we will get the power. So if we have one quantity with us, then we can easily find out the another quantity. So let these two, energy and powers, are nothing but at instant, these are the instantaneous power at instant t. Okay, so as these are the instantaneous power, but we need complete duration power as well as the energy. So for that purpose, what we should do, for that purpose we have E of t, this is our previous formula, P of t into t, this is the instantaneous power. But suppose I will integrate this, that will give us complete power, or the, we can say, normalized power. Similarly, if I want power, what I will do, this is E of t from this, and I will divide it by time duration. So these are the basic concepts regarding the energy and power of a signal. But remember one thing, what is our aim? To understand the difference between energy signal and the power signal. But for that purpose, we should know how to calculate energy of the signal as well as how to calculate power of the signal. Same discussion we have done while we have seen the signals and system, and fortunately or unfortunately, I was your instructor, and at that time I have repeated the same concept that I am doing right now. Okay, so these are the two formula, and more importantly, if we want to use this formula in a very proper manner, so the next formula will be P equals to limit t tends to infinity 1 upon 2t integration from minus t to t x of t whole square with dt, correct? And what is the formula for energy? Energy is nothing but, again, limit t tends to infinity minus t to t mod of x of t whole square dt. Okay, this square should be, this square should be what? It is mod square. And why we are taking mod? Because you know that minus 2 and plus 2 square is 4. So when we square anything, the concept of what sine is completely neglected. So for that purpose, we have taken the mod operator. Okay, but now this is regarding the continuous time signal. But what this formula for the discrete time signal, if you remember, if you recall from our previous discussion in signals and system, same thing we have repeated in the signals and system. These are all for the continuous time signal. Why? Because I have used the integration. But suppose I want to use these concepts for the discrete time signal. So for that purpose, what we have to do? We have to change our what? Thinking. Correct? Because we are dealing with the discrete time. So that's why the formula will be now. Formula will be, I am using the red ink now for the better understanding purpose. So P will be nothing but summation what? N varies from minus n to plus n mod of x of n square. And one thing again it will have 1 upon 2n plus 1 writing in a better manner. So P is limit n tends to infinity. Correct? Now what is the significance of infinity? That we are considering the duration of the signal. So duration of the signal means its starts point and its end point. So what, how, from where the signal is starting and where it is ending, that we don't know. From where the sunlight is, from which time the sunlight is available and from where it is zero, I am not asking regarding the 24 hours only. I am asking the past of the sun. Correct? So we don't know the duration of the sunlight and we cannot say how much long it will be available. Correct? So that's why same thing happens with the signal, because sunlight is a one type of signal. So same thing happens with our day-to-day signal also. Its end point and start point we don't know, and that's why we have to take a help of the infinity. Okay, so this becomes the P equals to limit n tends to infinity 1 upon 2n plus 1 summation minus n to n mod of x of n square. Now, next is, what will about energy? Energy will be now, only what, which change I should make now in this formula? Instead of power, I should write energy first of all, and then what, which thing I should remove? I should remove this. So if you remove this, then the same formula is for the energy. Now what is the concept of this 2n plus 1? From where the concept of 2n plus 1 is arising? I will simplify this one. Let us say there is a signal x of n equals to 1 1 1, arrowhead is here, so 0 minus 1 1. Okay, so what is the duration of this signal? Here n is varies from minus 1, these are the values of n, minus 1, 0, 1. So there are 3 points for 3 values of n. Okay, so capital N is, so if you equate this 2n plus 1 equals to 3, that is nothing but, so therefore what will happen here? will erase this. Okay, so see here, n is varies from minus 1 to 1. So how many points it has covered? It has covered 3 points, minus 1, 0 and 1. So always there is a 1 point extra. Always when we deal with the discrete time signal, we have to consider 0th sample always. Okay, for n equals to 0, we should take into the consideration. So that's why there is 1 point extra. That's why the plus 1 is available and with 2n. Okay, so 2n plus 1. So now what is the value of capital N here? So capital N is here 1. Capital N is 1. Why 1? Because when you equate 2n plus 1 equals to 3, then you will find that